VEO3 is the video creation engine of Google's Gemini, and it just leveled up big time. It now has... Now your videos can come to life with sound and even speech from a simple prompt. You can create videos like these.
Oh my love, oh my dear.
The Hi Tech Nomad here, and welcome to another video. This video is on video. Specifically, we're going to be at VEO3, which is the video creation engine of Google's Gemini, part of the new Gemini 2.5. Each company is not only developing their own AI, but also their own graphic engine, which can produce images or videos or both. The one for ChatGPT is called Sora, and we're going to be taking a look at that in another video. But the reason I want to look at VEO today is because they just added a new feature, which is the next level. And that is that they've added sound. You now can describe your video and describe what sounds you want to hear or what you want the people in your video to say, and it will do that. It's pretty amazing to see. There are some limitations. We can't use famous individuals. We can't use their actual speech. And our videos are going to be only 8 seconds long. Obviously, we're not going to be doing any 2-hour blockbuster videos at this point. However, this is enough for you to start to figure out how to write prompts, because this is different from writing prompts for ChatGPT or the other AIs that you may have used.
You try it for free. I have a code in the description that will allow 3 people to try out Google AI Pro for 4 months free. If you're one of those lucky 3 people, go and grab that code. Now, when we get into Gemini, as you can see, gemini.google.com, this is similar to ChatGPT, the other AIs, where we have the bar on the side and our chat window, and then we can start typing what we want to see or the answer we're looking for. We also have a video button. Click on this button. I'm going to click on video again. It says you can have up to 8 seconds. You're the director. What do you want to have? And I can say something like a pumpkin driving a car in the woods while singing happy birthday. We can hear birds in the background.
A few moments later.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday, dear.
Happy birthday to you.
I don't know about you, but to me, this is reminiscent of a Geico commercial or something. I mean, it really does seem like this is a commercial piece of video. If I didn't know that I had just created it, I would assume that it was made professionally. There are some issues with this. First off, we can't hear the birds in the background. While he is singing happy birthday, there are some demons or something that say happy birthday, dear. I don't know who that's supposed to be. Let's take a look at another example.
Happy birthday to you.
Happy birthday.
This time we're going to ask it to do an anime-like scene, so we've got a sort of that claymation piece, and so now we're going to try and do a cartoon style.
Who will teach us how to use this? Sensei Orman will teach us.
Here's another prompt, and this one's kind of interesting. They have copyright laws and certain restrictions, so you have to be careful about what you say. You can't say, give me a scene from Star Trek, but I can say, give me something that looks or that inspires or gives you the feel for Star Trek. Now, this one's very interesting because I did give a very detailed prompt. However, we are going to get a different look than what I described here. And that's because if you don't say it in the right way, then you don't get what you were looking for.
What is scene?
I see many new AI movies being created.
So in this scene, this is not what I envisioned. I wanted it to look like a scene from Star Trek, the classic. semicircle with people all around, but I didn't describe that. While I did say semicircle, I didn't say I needed five or six people in the background, all facing forward. So I said the captain should say, "What do you see?" But it came out as, what is seen? I'm not sure why I took that liberty. I guess it's his first day on the job. He looks around like he doesn't know if the camera's running. If you were to see this, would you realize I created this from a prompt? In this next example, I'm going to try to recreate the punchline from a joke. And the punchline is, it's the plumber. He came to fix the sink. If you remember what joke that is, please let me know down in the comments.
We still have to get to that same level of specificity to get exactly what we want.
Who is it? What? He's the plumber. He came to fix the sink.
So there's a couple of problems here. The first thing is, I had to say that the man was sleeping because you can't say that he's because that might trigger something. So we have to say he's sleeping, even though we said some kind of coronary attack.
The next thing
that's a problem is that the woman is supposed to say, who is it? And the parrot's supposed to say, it's the plumber. He's come to fix the sink. And the woman says it. So this more gives me the feeling like it's dementia than it is the conversation between her and the parrot. So let's tweak the prompt and try it again and see what we get.
Who is it? He's the plumber. He came to fix the sink.
So this is a little different. In the prompt, it says, who is it? Parrot squawks and says, I'm the plumber. I've come to fix the sink. But in this case, if you watch closely, she squawks, not the parrot. It sounds similar to her. Her lips aren't moving. It should have been more of a male voice. You really have to work on this to get it the way that you want. However, even now, you could use this for viral videos by describing something or a couple buzzwords and get really professional-looking clips. 8 seconds doesn't seem long. However, you'll see you can get quite a bit done. This is your first look at VEO3. If you like this video and want to keep up, please hit the like button. Please hit the subscribe button. Thank everyone for helping us get finally to 25,000 users. So for all you newcomers who have signed up, thank you. And for those of you who are not, what are you waiting for? Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Be sure to check out our podcast, newsletter. And until the next time, this is Orman Beckles, a.k.a. The Hi Tech Nomad, signing out.
Who is it? He's the plumber. He came to fix the sink.